practice. Well, Sarbanes-Oxley is a really big law aimed primarily at protecting stakeholders of securities markets, shareholders of corporations, buyers and sellers of securities, based largely upon the negative economic effects it has when corporate practice causes a devaluation or uncertainty in the market. So by and large, what it did was it changed the focus of corporate governance practice largely. It caused corporations to put more emphasis on and comply with regulations for shareholder fairness. And it also embraced the stakeholder theory and required corporate governors to take into consideration the interest of external stakeholders other than just the shareholders of the corporation, that is employees as well, or third parties affected by corporate governance practice. It required corporations to have ethics codes or provisions that kind of set the standard for particular governance practice in the organization, and required heightened duties on officers and directors of the corporation in carrying out their duties. So it raised the potential for liability of officers and directors in under their duty of care to the organization. Okay. Largely, however, the most important aspects of the law were the increased disclosure requirements and the accountability of officers and directors for that disclosure, and then the potential liabilities there for failures in corporate governance practice. So if we focus on the accounting aspect, it required extensive public disclosures, certified accounting statements. It formed the Professional Company Accounting Oversight Board, which governs the auditing firms that come in and audit public corporations and put additional standards on them that the corporation and the auditing firm has to meet. It requires executives to certify the accuracy or correctness of information reported to the public. So there was a great deal of emphasis on these accounting practices by the PCOAB. And then the securities law regime was affected in that it focused again on insider trading aspects, anti-fraud provisions. It added criminal liability action for certain violations or conspiracies to violate the securities law. And it added some whistleblower provisions for individuals who report procedures or failures to follow some of the prescribed procedures for public disclosure in that way. So collectively, what's important to know is that Sarbanes-Oxley added a good number of governance provisions that affect the conduct of officers and directors in their primary function in the organization.